Hello, today we are going to make a lollipop or hand fan. Inflate a balloon leaving about 1 inch flat tail. Twist a chain of the first two soft about 1 inch bubbles. For this sculpture I prefer to use clear bright colors balloons. Now we are going to lock both ends of the first and both ends of the second bubble in one lock twist. Twist the third about 5 inch bubble. Lock both ends of the third bubble in one lock twist. Our next step is to measure the size of the fourth bubble. Roll the balloon around the third bubble. We have to make sure there is no gaps between bubbles. It helps if you stretch the balloon or make it a bit soft. We have to make full loop around the third bubble. At this spot we twist the fourth bubble and lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. Now we gently force the third bubble inside of the loop of the fourth bubble. Our sculpture is supposed to have a circle shape, not a ball, so it's kind of flat. Here we are, front view, side view. Pretty much that's it. We have made small size sculpture. We can use the rest of the balloon to make a handle, or we can make a bigger size sculpture. Let's make it bigger. Measure the size of the fifth bubble. Work in the same fashion. Roll the balloon around the fourth bubble to measure the size of the fifth bubble. Twist the fifth bubble and lock both ends of the fifth bubble in one lock twist. The rest of the balloon is a sixth bubble. It is a handle. Force the sculpture inside of the loop of the fifth bubble. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations! We have made the lollipop or the hand fan. As always, there are different ways to make similar sculptures. So here is another variation. Inflate a balloon leaving about 1 inch flat tail. Actually, we will need less than that. This time I want to make a spiral shape. We are going to roll the balloon in a spiral shape starting from the nozzle. Let's twist very long first bubble leaving about 7 inch at the end of the balloon to make the handle. Twist the second soft about 1 inch bubble. Twist the third soft about 1 inch bubble. Lock all ends of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. The rest of the balloon is the fourth bubble. It is the handle. Now we have to roll the first bubble in a spiral shape, starting from the nozzle. Fold the balloon about 2-3 inch away from the nozzle. And roll the first bubble around itself. Make sure there is no gaps between rolls. It's okay if the balloon jumps out of your hands like that. It happens to me all the time. Very often it happened to me when I'm in a rush to get a lollipop. There is only one way to make it right. Slow down and make the spiral. Mark the spot where we're going to twist the bubble, right here. At this spot we're going to split the first bubble on two bubbles. So let's unfold the spiral and twist the fifth bubble. Lock both ends of the fifth bubble in one lock twist. And now we are going to again roll the first bubble in a spiral shape, starting from the nozzle. We do it in exactly the same way as we have done it previously. Fold the balloon 2-3 inches away from the nozzle and roll it around itself. Then we gently force the spiral of the first bubble inside of the loop of the fifth bubble. Make sure there is no gap at the center of the spiral. In this example, we gonna have one little gap between bubbles at the base of the handle. It's a place where we connected all bubbles together in one lock twist. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations again, we have made the lollipop. We can use this sculpture as it is, as a decoration. We can fix the handle in different positions. Also, we can use it as a hand fan or Chinese fan. As part of large sculptures, we can use it, for example, to make eyes. Let's put sculptures next to each other so we can see the difference better. Oh, let me shape this handle too. That's our two lollipops, and we can use it as monster eyes or the alien eyes. Okay, you got the idea. We can do many different things with lollipop. One of the things is we can make it bigger. In this example, I use additional yellow balloon to make one more bubble. As you can see, I'm doing it in exactly the same fashion as we did previously. Stretch the balloon around the sculpture, mark the spot, twist the bubble, lock both ends of the bubble in one lock twist. And then we force the sculpture inside of the loop of this big yellow bubble. Work it gently. Cut off the rest of the yellow balloon, tie off the ends, hide the ends between the bubbles. Congratulations again, we have made very large size lollipop with no sugar in it, zero cholesterol, zero calories, absolutely not eatable. Have fun and happy twisting!